refereeing in the country, and the image of refereeing in Ghana was battered to the ground, leaving the country without any referees for CAF assignments. And many said it would take a great deal to restore the image of referees in the country. Now, here's a report by my colleague Daniel Yeboah from day two of the FIFA and CAF ongoing referees integrity seminar.
Also, most important thing is how to referee, because the new championship is going to start very soon. So that's why also this is the purpose of this course. Okay, my role also is to bring them the new concept, how to referee a game. This is the most important, how to referee a game.
Ghana refereeing took a big hit in 2018 when the expose on bribery and corruption hit the game. Football coming to a standstill in Ghana was largely due to the indiscipline and unprofessional conduct of some match officials in the game. The return of the local game will largely depend on the levels of the referees. Their quality, integrity and general professionalism could enhance the excellence of the Premier League, Division 1 League and the Women's League. The GFA's aim of having a cleaner game will require the Referees Association of Ghana producing officials of international quality. The three-day program to help raise the standards of the referees was observed by FIFA and CAF instructor Lim Ki Chong, who was pleased with the levels of integrity test.
Test is about a lecture, a presentation about integrity to make them aware of what they should do, what they are expected and what they are exposed to, because now football is a business. So there is a lot of money involved. So they have to be very careful, because some, you know, referees, they are vulnerable. You know, when people, some want to offer those, also whatever they offer, but they have to resist. This is the word, to resist. This is to resist, of course, and then to report. This is the most important thing, to report if there is someone want to corrupt them.
On day two, the 311 referees were grouped into two, practical and theoretical. The two groups were taken through different drills that helped build their standards. They were taken through the laws of the game while building their fitness levels for the grueling matches ahead of the new season. The top flight resumes on December 27 to 28, and Ghanaians will hope to see a better overall football tournament organized across the league centers.